We're off to the movies now, and Jason Statham returns to the big screen in an action-packed thriller called The Beekeeper.
The one-man army seeks vengeance in this knock-em-out adventure, also starring Josh Hutcherson.
Weekend Sunrise movie man Jason Jabba Davis joins us now. Morning to you, Jabba. What's this like?
Jabs, it's a head shake already in the intro. A head shake in the intro cannot...
Bad.
That's a
bad omen. Doesn't spell much good.
Matt, man, I thought, you know, what can I bring you for your first Jabba's movies of 2024? I'll bring you some gold, something worthy of an Oscar. Instead, I bring you something worthy of a Rotten Tomato. Imagine, if you will, a scriptwriter on a bender who decides to binge watch all the Bourne movies, all the Hunger Games movies, and then continues that bender, writes a screenplay that combines elements from the Hunger Games and the Bourne movies, adds in Jason Statham, adds in some Just for Men for Beards, and bees. And this is what you get.
I'm a beekeeper. I protect the hive. Sometimes I use fire to smoke out hornets.
This is a multi-million dollar operation. Okay, so you can't come up here white knighting. Will you stomp his ass out, please?
Honey, 10 times as bad as the worst movie you've ever seen.
Really?
It's in cinemas now.
That's a big call. If it's 10 times as bad as the worst movie you've ever seen,
and
don't
still
give it half a star.
Yeah, what got it the half a star? Yeah.
What, do you feel compelled to offer half a star?
Not good at maths. I thought you could give it zero, and then, like with Google reviews, you can't do a zero. Half or a one is the lowest you could go.
Okay,
I thought half
really?
Was good.
Okay.
It was hard to come up with a tagline for that. It's like some AI-generated script that turns up somewhere and people just glance at it and shoot a movie. It is. I shouted at the screen the whole time, so apologies.
Did you eat anything good while you were... Maybe that's where the half a star
any good snacks,
come
like
up.
A boysenberry
No, Ruby threw popcorn at me to try and get me to shut up, to stop shouting at, oh, she's the president!
Right.
Jabs, another Elvis story lands in cinemas. This time the lens focuses on Priscilla. Tell us about it.
Well, it's four times better than The Beekeeper. That's a little clue for the score. Opening on Thursday. Don't buy a ticket to Priscilla expecting similar good vibes from Baz Luhrmann's Elvis. This is the yin to Baz Luhrmann's yang. Priscilla takes away most of the shine from the King of Rock and Roll, based on her 1985 memoir, Elvis and Me, which details how the pair met in 1959 when Priscilla was 14 and Elvis was 24. So we see a schoolgirl charmed and courted by a man 10 years her senior before becoming a tortured wife and mother. It's pretty bleak.
I want to be there in the first place, Matt. Daddy, I'm not your claim, Matt. I don't go imagining things.
Like Aunt Margaret? Scooby?
That's it, woman. I don't want to hear another word.
Well, is there something you're hiding?
I don't have a goddamn thing to hide. You're just being too goddamn aggressive and demanding. You know, I think you should go see your parents for a little while. I think you should. Matter of fact, I'll help you. Start packing.
It's pretty hard not to be judgy about a 24-year-old and a 14-year-old starting a relationship. This is a lot of style over substance. Return to Sender, 2 stars. I've got to say, Jacob Elordi, he plays Elvis. He's currently the hottest thing on the planet for anyone under 25 from Saltburn. And Kaylee Spaney gives it her all as Priscilla. But where's the script?
Wow, that looks really interesting, though. Forget that.
It does, yeah. Damning and scathing reviews from Jabs today.
Yeah, welcome back, guys. Jabba's Movies 2024, setting the bar.
Thank you, Jabs.
Thanks,
always good
guys.
To talk to you, nonetheless.